game on. It's game on. We are big on sports. Big on sports.
Definitely welcome back from that short break. Well, in case you're just joining us, once again, welcome to the show. But what a weekend in terms of sports. What stood out for you? I would certainly love to hear from you. But quickly, let's get to move on with the show, because last week there was a meeting between the FUFA president, engineer Moses Magogo, plus a whole bunch of ex-internationals of the Uganda Cranes. So many of them, from the likes of Jackson Bayanja to Sam Simba to Issa Sekatawa, the likes of Stephen Bengo, the likes of Stephen Bogere, among so many of them. And so many issues were raised, especially how the ex-internationals can be a part of the game of football. But quickly, before we jump into that conversation, let's get here from the former Uganda Cranes player, also the head coach of URA Football Club. That is Sam Simba speaking after the meeting.
In fact, it has been long overdue to meet with FUFA. If there is honesty, as the president has been saying, then we have started a good journey, because we are lacking so many things. Most of us concentrated on playing football only, so we are lacking so many things. In summary, if we are to progress, we need to organize our association first, because you have heard that we are no longer in the books of FIFA. We are under players, and we are no longer players. But if we can organize ourselves very well, and FUFA also gives us a hand, we shall progress. And it has been fruitless. If there is honesty, I'm saying it again, if there is honesty and what the president has been saying, it has been very good. But if it's the other way around, we have wasted our time.
Interesting insights there from Sam Simba, quite the straightforward man. He'll always tell you his mind. And interestingly there, he says he's only hoping that FUFA can actually get to fulfill, definitely led by engineer Moses Magogo. Quite interesting there from Sam Simba. But ultimately, the target is they come up with an association of ex-internationals. And, you know, engineer Moses Magogo says, listen, guys, at the end of the day, are we need to come together? Are we going to have so many meetings to discuss what is the way forward? But this comes down to the pressure that these guys have actually been mounting and them feeling like they've been left out.
I tell you what. First of all, the ex-international association is no longer there in the boots from FIFA. FIFA saw it unnecessary to have the players association as well at the same time having the ex-international. So ex-international ceases to be. Now we do have the players association, but players association are headed by the former players. Not the current players that are still playing, the active players, but it is led by the ex-players. So, to me, it is a good thing. All along, this is what we've been crying for FUFA. It should always engage the concerned parties. Because whenever people do have concerns and you don't listen to them, it's like you are a dictator or Nache Marida. You are running the federation as if you are running your home. Now, if FUFA and Magogo, they have realized their mistake, if it is not political, the way I see it, why is it that all along FUFA has been reluctant to meet different stakeholders?
Yep.
Now, we are heading to 2021. Moses Magogo and the course, now they are coming up, meeting each and everyone. Now, even if you thrust on, those guys will attend before they have been reluctant. So if it's not a political thing, it is a good thing now that they have realized maybe their mistake and they should always engage.
I hope it's the interesting thing, because some will argue it's long overdue. We've seen players like Andrew Fimbo Mukasa in dire state calling for help. Obadiah Semakula, the same. There was a conversation around, you know, so many ex-players, how they've been living in a very poor state. And now some of them argue that the disunity they've had within themselves has actually been their biggest ending. Is this the time for the ex-internationals to come together and come up as one voice?
Well, I'm glad that this time around they had a mature conversation with FIFA. The last time ex-officials visited Mayengo, FIFA offices, they were throwing stones. They wanted to, you know, destroy the offices, which I think that was not the best way to air out your grievances, most especially coming from people that were professional before, people that, you know, players look up to. But I think for me, and also meeting FIFA is the right thing, because these guys, like we've always mentioned, that they were our heroes some time back, and now whatever happened, we just know the best way to be, you know, be treating them. And them meeting FIFA, probably they'll, you know, try and help them. And let's wait and see what happens. But I think going forward, this shouldn't be happening. Because the bigger question, Brian, we should be asking ourselves, how long will this keep happening? As much as we are looking at the ex-players, you know, trying to work together and, you know, work with FIFA to erase whatever has been happening, footballers wallowing in poverty shouldn't be happening. Because as a football player, you should be looking at other options when you're still playing. There are so many things that should be learning. I actually thought maybe going forward we shall get to talk about all these things. We don't have so much time to, you know, dive into all that. But I think there's a lot to talk about. Players need to be educated. There's so much. They need to be mentored. It's not about giving the fans who are intervening and giving fans. I think they have to go back to the grassroots, visit these clubs, counsel them, give them a lot of lessons going forward. Because as a football player, you have to plan after, you know, your football career.
It reminds me of Ivan Itege. There's a time he came out and said, as FIFA, they cannot absorb all the ex-internationals. Not everyone can work at FIFA. Patrick Itege, rather. Yeah. Not everyone can actually work at FIFA. Not everyone can become a coach. So they've got to be creative. Yes. And someone will be wondering, what can ex-internationals who didn't earn that much back then be able to do?
And no, not that they cannot absorb all of them. Because if we are talking of ex-internationals, are they like at 10K plus?
Yes.
They are more than the number that the federation can take. For them, they are saying there are so many opportunities at the federation that they can share among themselves. But still, it is not true. By the way, one person who has weakened these people, it is the federation themselves. Because there is a time when these ex-players were together, and maybe because of political differences, Simba, Simogre, they have a different thinking, and then the other pro FIFA, they do have a different thinking. At the end of it, you see them are being divided. Okay. Now some group goes there, the other one goes there, and it was the responsibility of the federation to ensure that they bring these people together such that they work for football. Not that every ex-player will work at the federation.
Right.
But still, like Asia said, we need to put measures so that at least they can benefit.
Okay, quickly, let's get to hear from Jackson Mayanja, Mia, saying a thing or two about the meeting.
I think it has been very good that the FIFA president has called us, and he had many voices from different type of people, from media, social media, every type of angle he has been hearing about the ex-internationals, seeing people dying and everybody talking about very different opinions, very different perspectives, until when he called us. And I think this is the first and the beginning of helping the ex-players, because so many things have been said. And this has also caught on me, touched me as Jackson Mayanja, because one time I came out with a video talking about the same issues. So, and I think this meeting is not the first and it's not the last one. And it's going to help everybody in the association, in the ex-internationals. So I thank the federation for this. And it shouldn't be taken that all players, even the current players, because this is the last respect apart from the last breath of a human being, but this is the last respect of any football player, this house of ex-internationals.
Definitely, there you go. That is Jackson Mayanja. But quickly, guys, As we get into that short break right now, Cameroon have come out and declined the opportunity to host both, that is the CAF Champions League finals. Do you remember they were awarded the rights earlier this particular year? That is by CAF. And they are saying due to the COVID-19 pandemic, as the country Cameroon, they are not in a position to actually be able to host both the semi-finals and the finals as well. There's been a conversation that Rwanda could actually be considered. Some folks believe that we could actually see the semi-finals and the finals are being taken all the way into the Middle East. But well, that is something quite interesting that does get come. That is an update from CAF. That being said, let's get into that short break. When we come back, results from Italy, results from Spain at the English Premier League, and tell you what, Formula One as well, and a massive win there for Lewis Hamilton, as he also had quite the gesture in terms of equality and equal rights movement, especially for the black. When we come back, that and so much more right here on Game On.
Game on. It's game on. We are big on sports. Big on sports.